been a little while. I'm back again. In the time that I've been gone, I've actually been involved in a whole bunch of like different book clubs. The one that I'm most active in though is the Busy Bee Book Club, held by Erin from Booked and Busy. That's her channel. I'll link it in the description. And in August, we read The Rage of Dragons. That book was phenomenal. I'm pretty sure I've talked about it before, but if not, I'll also be linking my Goodreads in the description as well. I was lucky enough to be able to participate in the Burning Book Tours. It is the promotional tour for Evan Winter's second book, The Rage of Dragons. By the time this goes up, it should be the second day of the tour, and there's a whole host of like people who are posting, who are making vlog posts, who are making videos, things like that. I would definitely check out the tour schedule that I'll include at the bottom as well. And I want to say a thank you to Caffeine Book Tours for the book and for the opportunity to get this early and read it. It's definitely one of my most anticipated sequels to be coming out for sure. Following this is just going to be a little vloggy vlog of my experience, and then I'll be back at the end for a little outro. Okay, enjoy. Going to be a recap in the beginning of the chapter. Bad. It wasn't unnatural. It was fine. It didn't feel like an info dump type thing. I mean, a little bit, but we got something out of it, so it's okay. Same day still. See, shirt. Now I'm having some yogurt. Anyways, I've only gone to chapter 2 now. Oh, man, I just love Tao so much. I love the way Tao's character is written. He hasn't really even done much, but I don't know. Just the way he'd be thinking, I'd be like, oh wow, what a great guy. I also love Hadith a lot. He's like the brains of the group. He has been since the first book, but he's also very much looking out for his sword brothers, you know? Like, two times already, he's kind of pulled Tao aside and been like, hey, are you good? You know, like, watch out for this, you know, make sure that, you know, that you're not getting into something that you don't need to be getting into, and I just appreciate him for that so much. So far, loving it. Yep. I haven't even got 100 pages in. But it's just really good. Tell me why Tao is already making some bad decisions. For everything I said yesterday, I actually can't stand him. As a matter of fact, I've decided that he's problematic in and of himself, and until he takes better care of himself, I think we should cancel him. That's my thoughts this morning. Just realized that all the events that have been happening in the first like 4 chapters are in 2 days, like the same 2 days so far. The same 2 days. How are they living? How is this happening? What I really love is that I'm seeing a lot of like good quotes, like discussions about what happens when you're a lesser and the rage that comes with it, that intensity, and why Tao is the way he is. He's angry not only because of the way his father died, but because of the fate that all his people deal with. Not the Omehi, but all lessers, anyone who's seen as less than just because of the way they were born. Like, they're like, we never were able to control this, but here we are, always branded less than the nobles when they're the ones that made the rules of what was great and what wasn't, you know? And I think that's really, it's really, really, I think it's really topical, to say the least. But I'm loving, like, that aspect of the novel so far. I'm on my way to do my laundry right now. I would record in my room, but my roommate's sleeping. It's very early on a Sunday morning. College kids are not awake. What was I saying?
But I just crossed the 50% mark, and ladies and gentlemen, we have gay people. I repeat, there are gay people. That wasn't the main update. I'll have more to say later, but I'm just excited right now because we have a couple. Evan Winters said, gay rights.
Filming this little update. I have, hold on, sticky notes. I have a lot of sticky notes. Not a lot, like two. I'm about 60% in, and what I've noticed now is that, well, I noticed this earlier, but I just never stopped to like film. Book one was definitely a lot like faster paced than this one. It was like, there was the introduction, and then we got into what we need to get into, and then boom, 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 we were in it, you know what I mean? And then now, in book two, we're already in everything, and everything's moving a lot slower. But, on the offhand, we're getting a lot more information. In the first book, a lot of things were like, that's just the way things are, until they weren't, if that makes sense. But now it's like, were you wondering how this made sense? Here's your explanation. And it's really interesting. Like, the lore of the book is very, very interesting. But event-wise, there's not too much happening. I mean, something definitely did happen. Like, when the title is, like, The Fires of Vengeance. And, of course, you're like, oh, yeah, Tao wants vengeance for, you know, his dad dying. But multiple fires of vengeance. Multiple fires. Lots of people have things they want revenge for. But I'll also say, as a character, Tao was kind of a bad friend, and like, we knew this in book one, but damn, he'd be talking to his homeboys, and I'm like, how do you not know like these basic things about your friends? Like, they're really there for you. His homies are 10 toes down, but does Tao know where their home village is? No, absolutely not. Mm-mm. No, not at all. And then there's the queen. I love her a lot. I love her character so far. She's a little firecracker. She's very cool. No, I just want to see good things happen for her. Suck what she's going through right now, but the sun is brightest after the storm. You know, I sincerely hope she gets well soon. So I finished the book. I definitely should have been doing like actual homework or anything else, but I didn't. Now we're here. Now it's finished. You ever read something and it ends with a line that is extremely foreboding, and you turn the page to see the next chapter, and then you get hit with a glossary? Thank you, Mr. Winter, for the experience. I literally just finished the book. I don't know what to say. Man, it's like how you pull some out in like the last page of the book, and then I have to wait now? Like, I have to live like this.
Cut the cameras. Dead ass.
Me again. Time to actually wrap up how I feel about the book. I don't know if I left in the actual last clip that I filmed. It was kind of bad, so I'm doing it again. So I finished The Fires of Vengeance, and I was definitely shell-shocked for quite a while. It ended really well. I'm really, really happy with a lot of things that happened in the book. I'm really happy with Tao's development. I love the way that his arc with Vengeance has gone. And I'm really, really excited for whatever happens next. There's a lot of like interpersonal things that happen in this book. It definitely is a slower paced novel for us to really get to know the characters, for us to really like, you know, connect with them and understand the lore of the kingdom a lot more, like who the Omehi are, where they came from, and why they are, you know, like this. And I think it's really, really interesting. I'm really excited for the third one. Now that I've read it so early, I'm really gonna sit here and be like, dang, give me the third one, you know? But congratulations again to Evan Winters on his sequel, and thank you one more time to Caffeine Book Tours for the book. I'm giving this a solid 4 out of 5 stars. I'll maybe bump it up to 4.5 depending on how I feel. Because of the pacing, there was nothing wrong with it, but like coming off of the first book, the pacing was a little like, it was a little jarring that it was so much slower. I think those are all of my thoughts. That's everything I want to say. If not, oops. But one more time, make sure you check the description for both the post to the Caffeine Book Tour's like launch post about the tour, and then the tour schedule itself. There's a good amount of people that are doing things for the tour, and I'm sure you'll find someone either new to subscribe to or someone that you probably like already. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you when I see you, because I'm in college. All right.